Hi guys, this is Nazmus Simab and you are watching Gateway Solution. In this video, I am going to solve an array question, a very good array question from lead code, and question goes like this. Given an array ARR, replace every element in that array with the greatest element among the element to its right and replace the last element with -1, because in last when we reach last element, we don't have any right element. So we will go with the example so that our understanding will be more in depth. So what we will do? We will see the input array here. The input array is 17, 18, 5, 4, 6, and 1 as element like this. And what will be, according to question, what will be our output array? So our output array will be something like this when we are at index 1. So we will see all the element right of it. So all among all the element right of it, greatest is 18. So here 18 will come when we will reach index 1. We have 18 as element and right of the element include 5, 4, 6, and 1. Among these whole element, greatest is 6, so it will be replaced by 6. Now we are at second index, and at second index we have 5, and on right of it, greatest element is 6, so it will be replaced by 6. And when we will reach the third index, we have at third index we have 4, and in right of it, the greatest element is 6, so it will be replaced by 6. But when we will reach 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, when we will reach fourth index, we have 6, and in right of it there is only one element, so greatest element is 1 only. So 1 will come here, and at last there is no right element, so we will, according to question, we will replace it with -1. Hopefully you got the question. Now we will see in whiteboard. The first we will see the simple approach. Let's take the array as, I will change the color of this, let's take the example array as something like 18, 17, 14, 6, 3. Yeah. In this array, what we will do first, we will give index to it 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So when we will at index, we will be at index 1. What we will do? We will replace it by max of the whole from here to here. We will replace it by max of 17, 14, 6, and 3, and max will be 17. Right. So it will get the same array. Same array will get overwritten, 18 will get overwritten by 17. So when we will be at index 1, what will happen? At index 1, again we will see the right, and right is 14, 6, and 3. So max of 14, 6, and 3 will be 14. When we will be at index 2, let's change the color. When we will be at index 2, what will happen? We will take max of 6 and 3. So max of 6 and 3 will be 6. When we will be at index 3, we have only one element here in the right. So that element will come here. And we will add, when we will be at last index, we will simply place -1. So in this way we will go, and what we have to do in our first approach, we will iterate over this array, and again we will iterate over the remaining element on the right. So we will use two for loop in the simple case. This is very simple, you can do this easily, but here our time complexity will goes to O of n square, which is not good solution. It is a bad solution, but we anyhow we reach the solution, we reach the output, but this is not the good solution. Now we will see a good solution, and good solution will be something like this. First we will observe a pattern in this. So again I will draw 18, 17, 14, 6, and 3. So our array is something like this, and index is like 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So what we will do, we will start with our last index, and according to question, last index should be -1. We will simply put it as -1. Let's see it here. We will make last index as -1. Now what we will do, we will store these three in a variable. Before making it -1, we will store this element in a tempo variable. Let's see it as, say it as 3, and in next state, when we will reach at this index by decrementing, when we will come to index 3, what we are going to do, when we will be at index 3, what we will do, we will see right of it. So right of it contain 3. So what we will do max of, as you know, we in temp we have max, we didn't lost it. So what we will do, max of 3 and -1. So max of 3 and -1 will be 3 here. So again index will get decremented. Now max of 3 and -1, and we have trace of -1. We have -1 when we like in previous step we found that we have 3, and now our, let's call it as some largest value equal to max of 3, and we will store largest value here. So when we will now, when we will again decrement it, and now we are at index 2. At index 2 again we will see right of it, and for seeing right of it, we will not iterate all this whole thing. What we will do, we will take this element 6, and we will find max of 6 and L, and in this case we have 6 and L, we have L as 3. So again L will get updated to max of 6 and 3, and max of 6 and 3 is 6. So now we will again decrement it. Now we are at index 1, and at index 1 we have 17, at index 1 we have 17, but right of it we have 14. So again, what we will do, we will find max of 14 and L. In this case, L is 6, so max of 14 and 6 will be 14. And at this position, and now we are at 0th index, and at 0th index, what we will do, max of next element, which is 17, max of 17 and L, and in this case L is 14 and it will be 17. So our final element will be like this, 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So our final array will be overwritten to this. And if you see, we started from here and we reached here and we didn't use any kind of other array. So time complexity for this solution will be big O of n, which is amazing, which means this is the best solution. So now we will code for this solution. So let's head toward our code and we'll go like this. So now code will go like this. What I will take first, a largest value, call it as L, and I will take initialize it with minus 1 because at last index minus 1 will go, and one tempo variable I have to take, and here is tempo variable, and I will initialize it with 0 at initially, and I will iterate over the array from last to first, okay, as we discussed in our whiteboard. So what it will be like, int I equal to n minus 1, and here is arr dot length minus 1, and we will start with the last index, and we will go till the first index till I greater than equal to 0 and I minus minus. Here we go, and inside it, what we have to do, first we have to store our last element in temp variable, because we want to, in next step, we want to max off the next, means last step, and the largest. So first what we will do, temp inside arr of I, the element at last position, we will store it into temp, and next what we will do, next we are going to do arr of I, and inside arr of I we are going to overwrite, we are going to overwrite arr of I with the max, with the largest value, and for now largest value is minus 1, and since when we are at the index n minus 1, our at n minus 1 index our value minus 1 is going to sit, so we initialize it with minus 1, and after that what we will do, we will find max, and we will update this L value, and in this L value we have to do what, in this L value we have to check first if L is greater than temp. If L is greater than temp, then what we have to do, in we have to do L and store L or temp. So I hope you understood this question. We have to check this statement. If it returns true, we are going to store L into L, and if it returns false, we are going to store temp into L. If you don't like this, you can use method.max also, and hopefully now we are good to go. This is the solution, and at last we have to return an array also. So I'm going to return the same array, since we have done in place operation, which is the best operation and which required least memory. So I will try to submit it now. Hopefully it will get accepted. Wow, it got accepted. Now let's see the detail, how we performed, how is our time complexity and all. Yeah, you are here, your runtime beats 99.89% of Java submission, means our solution is quite good. So that's it guys, hopefully you enjoyed the video and consider sharing and subscribing. Thank you.